This is a high-performance EV using what purports to be a great and green alternative to lithium-ion batteries. It's called the RG Natalie, and it's the world's first supercar powered by alcohol. Unlike your traditional EV, this one doesn't need to be plugged in or charged. You simply pour methanol into the tank. The fuel is then heated to somewhere between 300 and 400 degrees Celsius, the temperature at which carbon dioxide is emitted, and in turn, hydrogen atoms pass through the fuel cell, where energy is generated and sent to each of the four wheel hub electric motors. Quite similar, in fact, to how a hydrogen fuel cell works. So, this is convenient as a petrol car, but more so because it boasts a range of up to 700 miles. That is, according to its developer, Roland Gumper. Now, you may be wondering, is it really green? After all, it emits carbon dioxide. And the answer is, yes. The process by which methanol is produced actually draws carbon dioxide from the atmosphere, in perfect counterbalance to the car's emissions when it's used. One concern is that methanol fuel cells are relatively limited in the power they can produce, despite being good at delivering energy for long periods of time. That being said, some sources say the car is capable of 430 brake horsepower and speeds of up to 186 miles per hour. Only 500 units will be made, and each one is expected to cost. Well, we don't need to go there. But if the RG Natalie does indeed prove to be revolutionary, which Gumper is convinced will be the case, then why on earth wasn't it built sooner? If our fathers and our fathers' fathers tried to teach us anything, surely it's that alcohol is the solution to all of life's problems. For more information, check out the original article via a link in the description, and subscribe for more content.